So let's talk about things to consider when it comes to making a good quality bale. As you can see here, we've got a bale that's less than desirable. It's got a fluffy side, which means that maybe our density wasn't as tight as we'd like to have it. We've also got a side that's smaller than one, which means maybe we had trouble feeding the hay into the baler. And then also the net wrap's pretty loose on this bale. So those are all things that we need to keep in mind, and we'll talk more about when it comes to making a good quality bale. So one of the first places we can look when it comes to making a good quality bale is at our windrow. We want good windrow shape, and you can see here we're fortunate enough today to have enough volume of hay to make a windrow that's the full width of the bale chamber. That gives us the ability to drive straight down the windrow without having to weave or compensate for a narrow windrow. On the other hand, if we didn't have this much hay, we could make half the size of the bale chamber, and then we could weave to help continue the flow of the hay straight across the chamber of the baler. The other thing we want to keep in mind here is the height of our pickup reel. We typically try to set these so the teeth are about 1.5 inches off the ground when they're pointing straight down. That gives us the ability to get good hay into the pickup reel, but not dig in the ground or also not leave hay on the ground. So we know that when it comes to making a good quality bale, net tension or the amount of stretch that we get out of the net is important too. And when it comes to making a good quality package, the tighter we can get the net and the more we can get around that bale, the tighter it is, the better quality package we're gonna have. On the 504 Premium, we get to adjust the amount of tension on our net wrap right here with this brake system. You can see we've got a brake pad that runs against the drum here. And as the net goes on, this pad is putting pressure on the drum to help stretch the net as it turns. If we come and find that our net is too loose back here, we can simply adjust the tension right here with this T-bolt and this spring. We have a factory setting on the decal here of 4.8 inches, and that measurement is taken from the end of the bolt here to the last coil of the spring. So right now, I'm at 4.6 inches, and I know that that's probably too loose for the amount of stretch I want out of my net wrap. So to change that, we simply loosen this jam nut here, like so, and then we're able to increase the tension on our spring. By turning our T-handle in. So hopefully you'll see that that spring is getting longer, which means we're adding tension to the net wrap brake. Now if we measure, we're at 4.9 inches. So we're a little above what's recommended in the manual, but keep in mind, this is just a starting place. So we've adjusted our spring now, and we're at 4.9 inches, which means we've added tension to this spring, which means then we're gonna have more pressure on our brake pad here and on our drum that's turning the net wrap roll. So what we would do next then is make another bale of hay and check to see how tight the net is on the bale. And then we're gonna take a look at the net wrap itself back here in the net wrap attachment. And as the net feeds into the baler, we wanna start looking for little windows where the net is starting to break. And that tells us we're getting as much tension as we can without actually breaking the net before it feeds. So when it comes to making a good quality bale, hydraulic pressure, or the amount of density that we put on the bale, is important too. On the 504 Premium, we make that adjustment here on this side of the baler at our density gauge. We know that we want a good tight bale from the time it starts at the core until we've finished all the way to the outside. So we can get good pressure by changing that here on the density gauge. And we've got a gauge on the side of the baler that gives us an indication of how much pressure we have. So if we're too loose, we simply loosen this up and tighten it by turning it clockwise. And then we can open the tailgate all the way up, and our gauge on the right-hand side will show us where our needle is. Typically, we want to run maybe in the 1/2 to 3/4 top part of that green scale. So we've made some adjustments with our windrow. We talked about the importance of having a good box-shaped windrow. And keep in mind, if we don't have enough hay to make the full width of the bale chamber, we can make half that width and weave to keep that constant flow of hay into the baler. Also, we took a look at our net tension. And as you can see on this bale that we made after we made our adjustments, this net is pretty tight. And that's exactly what we're after. We're starting to see it go over the edge. We've got good square shoulders on this bale because the other thing we adjusted was our density. And we want this bale to be tight from the core all the way to the outside. So we got to keep in mind that the pressure we put on the bale makes a big difference in how tight it is and again, affects the quality of the bale after it comes out of the baler.